Evaluating endpoint security solutions is challenging. However, you can skip the complex proof-of-concept configuration and jump right into attack simulations by using the Evaluation Lab in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. This video shows how to set it up, run attack simulations, and review the results. In Microsoft Defender Security Center, select Evaluation Lab and Tutorials to get started. Then, select Setup Lab. The first step is to choose your lab configuration. There are three available. You can choose to run three machines for 72 hours each, four machines for 48 hours each, or eight machines for 24 hours each. The best choice depends on your evaluation priorities, more time with each machine versus testing larger scale attacks. The second step is to choose the threat simulator agents you want to install, and these include AttackIQ and SafeBreach. We recommend that you install both to give you the most flexibility when choosing the attack simulations that you want to run. If you want to use the attack simulator agents, you must also provide an email address and name. Last, review your choices and select Setup Lab to prepare your lab environment. Once the lab is set up, you're ready to add some machines to it. That's next. Adding machines to the Evaluation Lab is simple. Select Add Machine. Choose between Windows 10 and Windows Server 2019, and then select Add Machine. You don't really need to record the machine or username. However, you do need to save the password, since this is the only time you'll see it. Select Copy and paste it somewhere safe. When you're finished, select Done to return to the Evaluation Lab dashboard. You can add more machines later, or you can add them all at once, like we did here. Each of these machines have useful software pre-installed, including Microsoft Office, Sys Internals, and Java, helping you get up and running quicker. Notice too that these machines are on their own virtual network, which allows you to run advanced simulations like lateral movement without worrying about the safety of your environment. In the next segment, you learn about the simulations we provide that you can run on these machines. Under Evaluation and Tutorials, select Simulations and Tutorials, and then select the Simulations Catalog tab to see the simulations we provide that you can run in your lab. The catalog has three categories. Microsoft simulations are files or scripts that you run on machines. More on that later. The next group of simulations is powered by AttackIQ, and they require the AttackIQ simulation agent to be installed on the machine. Select Learn More to pop up the Details side pane to learn more about each one. The last group of simulations is powered by SafeBreach. As before, these simulations require the SafeBreach simulation agent to be installed on the machine. Next up, you'll see what it looks like to run an attack simulation and view the results. Running a simulation is simple. On the Evaluation Lab dashboard, select Create Simulation. Then, in the Create Simulation side pane, select the simulator and the simulation to run and the machine to run it on. In this example, I'll run the SafeBreach Known Ransomware Infection Simulator on Test Machine 4, mainly because it's a bit more dramatic than other simulators. You can check the status of your attack simulations at any time by selecting the Simulations tab. If you're curious what the attack looks like on the machine, you can connect to it by using Remote Desktop. Just select Connect and follow the prompts to connect to the remote VM. Once connected, you see the virus and threat protection notifications in the Notification Center. Select one to open Protection History, which shows you what I meant by dramatic. There was a lot of activity related to this attack. This attack also triggered an automated investigation, which the automated investigation page shows. Select the investigation to see the details side pane, and then select Open Investigation Page to see all the gory details, like the investigation graph, and associated alerts, machines, and evidence. You can certainly rely on the attack simulators to evaluate Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, but you have full access to the machines. Therefore, you're free to run any simulation you need on them. That's next. The Evaluations and Tutorials page provides tutorials with sample files and code you can run on your machines. While these are a great start, you're not limited to them. You can run any code you need to run on the machines. Some tutorials provide a file, while others provide a script. In this example, I want to explore the Fileless Attack tutorial, so I'll copy the Windows PowerShell script to the clipboard. Then I'll connect to Test Machine 3 by using Remote Desktop so I can run the script on it. Once connected to the machine, run Windows PowerShell as administrator and paste the PowerShell script that I copied to the clipboard and run it. After a few seconds, the script opens up a text file in Notepad that describes the attack and what to look for. Of course, like the previous attack, this one triggered an automated investigation in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. The last thing I want to show you is how to view the lab report. Coming up next. The top of the Evaluation Lab dashboard gives you a nice overview of your evaluation. Select See Full Report to get more detail. It includes a list of the incidents you generated, active alerts and their severity levels, threat categories and the number of alerts in each, detection sources, and actions taken by automated investigations. As with most of Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, you can select an incident in the report to open a side pane with more information. The Evaluation Lab in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint helps you more quickly evaluate the product's capabilities without complex endpoint and environment configuration. See Microsoft Docs for more information about it.